The brutality with which businesswoman Monica Kimani met her death was laid bare in court yesterday, as prosecution opened its murder case against journalist Jacqueline Maribe and her fiancé Joseph Franco. Emotions ran high as police investigator Jennifer Jepkowski presented photographs of Monica's body lying in a bathtub at her Lamria Gardens apartment in Kilimani, Nairobi. The prosecution produced a PowerPoint presentation of the crime scene. People who packed the court shook their heads in disbelief as the cruelty Monica was subjected to before her death became apparent. Some struggled to hold back tears as others looked away. Some of the pictures showed the victim's hands and legs were tied. Her throat was slit. In her opening statement, senior state prosecutor Catherine Wanicki said they had enough evidence to ensure a conviction. Ms. Kimani's death was not just another statistic or a news flash. She was a daughter, a friend, sister and business partner to many. Now she is gone forever and the question we are asking is why it had to end with the brutal killing, said Ms. Wanicki. Maribe and Rungu, who were once inseparable lovers, sat side by side listening keenly. Wanicki told the court that Monica was a determined young businesswoman who went beyond the Kenyan borders to Juba in South Sudan to fulfill her dreams, only to meet her death a few hours after getting back into the country. We will prove that Rungu was with her the night she was killed and that they conspired with Maribe to cover up the murder. We will prove that at the time of the incident there was no provocation or an incident of self-defense to justify the action, she said. Wanicki added that the prosecution had lined up witnesses who would prove that Rungu and Maribe were the principal offenders. We'll ask the court at the end of trial to find them guilty. The prosecution presented their first witness, Peter Marie Ukindkwa, who performed a post-mortem examination on Monica's body. Dr. Ngana said he performed the test on September 24 at Chiora Mortuary and that a look at the physical appearance showed Monica was in good health and energetic before her death. I noted that her body was paled, both hands tied with a strap and a visibly slit airway. The internal examination confirmed that her throat was slit through and through, and the veins which take blood to the brain completely cut off, he said. He told the court that Monica's internal organs were intact and that any sharp weapon could have been used to cut the throat. He concluded that the death was caused by excessive bleeding due to a severe neck injury and trauma. Ms. Jepkowski, who was the second witness, explained how investigators collected evidence at the murder scene. She will continue with her testimony today.